In a recent video, I demonstrated a honeycomb pattern that blends into the main body of a phone cover. It got me thinking about how I can do the same thing on a cylindrical face. On this pencil holder, we have a spiral honeycomb pattern that blends smoothly into the main body. Although the geometry looks complicated, the steps involved are actually quite simple. Also, surface tools are not required here. To summarize, we will be making two bodies. A twisted body that represents the overall shape, and a cylinder with a full honeycomb pattern debossed onto it. The two bodies will be intersected to produce a final result. Let's start a sketch on the top plane. We will be creating a sketch profile for sweeping the twisted body. Begin with a circle centered on the origin. The twisted body consists of three lobes. I'll be doing that with a spline. You can also attempt to do this using arcs. Let's first draw a vertical line from the origin. Convert this to construction. Start a feed point spline. Snap one end of the spline to the circle, followed by the end point of the vertical line. Lastly, snap to the other side of the circle. Go to Constraints, Symmetry. Select these two spline points, followed by the construction line as a symmetry line. This is to mirror the position of the two spline points. Dimension the position of one of the spline points relative to the construction line. Add a horizontal constraint to the top spline handle. The angle and length of the spline handles on either side are still free to move independently of each other. We need to make them symmetrical. First, slightly nudge the spline handles from their default position until they turn blue. Begin the symmetry constraint. Select the end point of this spline handle, followed by the end point of the other spline handle. Lastly, select the construction line. Both the angle and length of the spline handles are now mirrored. Add a tangent constraint between the spline and the circle. Dimension the spline handles. Go to Create Circular Pattern. Select the lobe as the object. And select the origin as the center point. Adjust the quantity to 3. In order to sweep this profile, we need a path. This path can be created either on the front plane or the right plane. Snap the top of the path to the origin. Go to Create, Sweep. Box select all profiles. For path, click on the select box and select the straight line. Add a twist angle of 360. Each lobe will make one full revolution as it moves down the path. Set orientation to perpendicular. Hide the body and bring back the sketch. Next, we are going to produce a cylinder from which to apply the deboss. The cylinder needs to fully encompass the three lobes. More specifically, it needs to be tangent to the spline and its apex. This is critical in ensuring that the honeycomb pattern takes the shape of the spline. Begin a sketch on the top plane. cut a circle from the origin, and snap it to the apex of the spline. Add the sketch for the twisted body, and extrude this circle into a cylinder. To control the extent, let's take reference from the twisted body. Bring back the twisted body. Select the bottom face and change the operation to a new body. Create a plane offset from the front. Hide both bodies. We will be sketching the honeycomb pattern on this plane. Bring back the path sketch. And project this line onto the current sketch plane. Let's hide the path sketch, and change this projected line to construction. Go to Create, Polygon, Circumscribed Polygon. Center this on the midpoint of the projected line. Adjust the radius and number of sides. Add a vertical constraint to this edge. Draw a line from the center to the midpoint of this edge. Change this to construction. We will be patterning the honeycomb in two stages. Go to Create, Rectangular Pattern. Double-click on one edge to select the whole chain of edges. For directions, click on the Select box and select this construction line. For distance type, change to spacing. Adjust the quantity and spacing. For direction type, set to one direction. Begin a second rectangular command. Select both hexagons. We will be using the standard X and Y directions in this case, so there's no need to choose directions. For distance type, set to spacing. Set both direction types to symmetric. Adjust the quantity and distance. If you need to change the parameters of the pattern, look out for the rectangular pattern icon and double-click. Or you can right-click and edit. Confirm the sketch and bring back the cylinder. When it comes to embossing, the pattern is allowed to exceed the height of the cylinder. The command will simply ignore the profiles in excess. However, in the X direction, the overall length of the embossed profile cannot exceed that of the circumference of the cylinder. Doing so would create an error during embossing. Go to Inspect, Measure. Clicking on the cylinder edge reveals its circumference. Keep this number in mind. The pattern has been done in a way that allows the honeycomb cells to interlock with each other as they wrap around the cylinder. We need to make sure that the lengths between these two edges do not exceed that of the circumference of the cylinder. We can also measure these two edges. While you are creating your own designs, you will need to adjust your pattern quantity and spacing accordingly to achieve a nice interlocked and at the same time not exceed the circumference. I would recommend to perform a save at this time. Go to Create, Emboss. Box select the honeycomb cells. For faces, click on the Select box and select the cylindrical face. Change the depth to 3. And change the effect to Deboss to cut into the cylinder. If we bring back the twisted body and go into the render workspace, we can see that the apex of the spline flushes with the emboss pattern. We just need to remove the excess honeycomb pattern. Go to Modify, Combine. Select the two bodies. For operation, set to Intersect.